Technique episode 17. In this lesson, we're going to focus on two closely related picking techniques that are referred to as the rake technique, most often applied to chord forms, and the sweep picking technique, which is most commonly applied to arpeggios. Now, these are two popular scale and arpeggio technical and performance ideas. It's used by guitar players within several different types of styles of music. So learning ways to develop them and learning how to properly practice them so that you'll be able to use them effectively is a really good idea because it improves your versatility. And that's, of course, important. So let's get things started here in part one of the lesson by learning about the discipline and the management related to using the rake technique. In exercise one, we're doing a disciplinary study. We're trying to get more management out of what's happening with the use of our hands. When we look towards what's going on with the fretting hand as opposed to the sweeping hand or the raking hand, picking hand, we have to have them aligned and working together in a very concise way. And that's how you're going to get that perfect, smooth sound when you're going across what's happening with this arpeggiated chord. Now, we're doing rake technique in particular here, so that's taking care of a down with the pick, a down motion, just sweeping across the strings. If you're not really good at that, of having a very smooth, you know, movement of the pick across the strings, one string at a time, really smooth, you'll want to practice that first. You may even want to turn the metronome on and do that until it starts feeling really smooth. And once that starts feeling pretty decent, I have three different exercises that you can try here. There's an A minor chord rake, and then there's an A major chord, and then there's also an A major 7 chord. So what's happening in the first one, in exercise 1A, we're taking this A minor triad on the top four guitar strings, starting there on that 7th fret 4th guitar string, and then we're barring with index finger to catch the 3rd, 2nd, and 1st strings. So you can tell too what I'm doing there when I'm executing that rake, my fingers lift off slowly off of every string. So the movement is very gradual, but it's happening very quickly when you speed it up. And I'm not really letting that ring as if it was a chord. I'm not holding everything down and going like this, because then it just sounds like a chord strum. There's nothing really differentiating it from something different, you know, in terms of hearing the notes more isolated. So that's, you know, a technique in and of itself for the fretboard hand, you know, where each finger is slowly kind of making its roll over to have each individual note give its, you know, true course. So we're not really hearing it again, like ringing as if it was a chord. The other thing too is, when you go across the notes, you're going to have to work for a while to be able to have the tracking. The tracking between left and right hand is really vital for this technique. So that's where, again, where the technique can get a lot of help by using metronomes. Let's take a look at what's happening in exercise 1B, because exercise 1B has a major triad. So what we have to do is raise the C tone up to a C sharp. And now we have A, C sharp, E, and the octave of A there. Now, it's a bit of a diagonal line there because we have the 7th, 6th, and 5th frets that come across. And then on the top note there, we have that high A. So we're having the 5th fret. So, you know, you have to kind of watch, you know, it's a little bit different feel than when we were doing the minor chord. The minor was more of a bar where we were rolling that finger across. Here we have to lift off. You know, we have the middle finger coming in. We're lifting them off very quickly to get that rake effect. And then the last one in exercise 1C, what's happening there is we've got a major 7 chord. So we've got A, C sharp, E, and then we're adding in on top the G sharp, 4th fret, 1st string. That turns everything into a really strict diagonal line that goes right across the guitar fingerboard there. And again, the technique, you know, I'm speeding it up kind of rapidly here, but when you're working on it, you'll probably, again, want to start by just, you know, making sure that drop pick is happening very smoothly with the picking hand. And then the other aspect is having the fingering hand for the fretboard to be moving off those notes very rapidly. It's, you know, it's almost like you're just fluttering across each one, but they have to be really well matched to what's happening with the picking hand. So, you know, if they're out of alignment, if they're out of sync, if they're not synchronized, you're gonna have kind of flub note problems. So you have to really work well on having a nice synchronization between left and right hands there. So that's all of the studies that are involved in exercise one. We have the A minor, we have the A major, and we also have that A major 7 chord. So, you know, work on those ideas, take them slowly, and then when you feel ready that you got them not bad in that position, start moving them along the neck, you know, just take them fret by fret. You know, you can change them up, you know, you could do some of them as majors, could do some of them as minors. It's up to you, you know, and you can do the same thing with the major 7. And you can add to them too. You know, if you do a major 7, it sounds kind of nice to maybe do a kind of a spin on the top note, because there's your major 7 and there's your octave on top. You know, you can do some really cool things like that. You can come up with some pretty interesting legato accents to everything. But, you know, that's for after you get the general technique down. So anyway, that wraps up our first video here. For exercise one, you know, we've gone over a little bit on the hand discipline and the management that it takes to do this technique. And we're going to move on to doing much the same in part two of the lesson. In the next video, we're going to take a look in exercise two at sweeping 2 and 3 string groups only. Again, just to help the management and the overall discipline that has to happen with that strum hand, with that pick hand. Because once you can get that very well organized and you have everything aligned, these techniques come together rapidly. But to get up to that level, it could take a while. I have to warn you, sometimes I've had students even of my own where it's taken months before they feel really comfortable with the rake technique or the sweep technique. So take your time doing this exercise and realize that, you know, at some point, one day, it's just going to happen for you and it'll feel very comfortable. So we'll wrap up this video and come back into the next video where we're going to take a look at sweep picking next. That was an excerpt from the 17th lesson of my guitar technique course. The remainder of this lesson, three more videos on top of this one, is available behind a paywall on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. But I thought you'd like to see this segment, so I put it here on YouTube for you to get a better idea about what this guitar technique course actually has to offer. If you want to subscribe to my website, you're going to gain access to this course along with my introductory, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs, plus many other guitar courses on the website. Just head over to creativeguitarstudio.com, sign up with a free lifetime membership to get started. Then you can always upgrade into either a monthly or you could go with the discounted yearly premium membership plan. If you have any questions, you can reach me either by phone or by email through the day. Just click on the link in the YouTube description box under where it says become a member today. Improvising a rock lead is a must-have skill for every guitarist. This lesson plan shows how to combine 7-tone scales, arpeggios, and pentatonics to create more interesting rock solos. The focus throughout the lesson plan is placed upon using embellishments like slides, vibrato, bends, hammer-ons, and pull-offs. As a bonus, a complete rock song is included for jamming over at home. Rock lead soloing is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching part one of the lesson. Sign up for a membership at creativeguitarstudio.com to watch the rest of this video. Up next, we'll study sweep picking technique and the melodic application behind both sweep and rake picking. Plus, as a member, you'll also be able to download the handout for this lesson, along with many more professional guitar lessons. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch up next in the members area.